Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom. Oh, freedom over me and before I be a slave.
Hello, I'm Minister Jason Turner, and this is a New Hope Baptist Church educational series titled Black Heroes of Faith in American History, where we take a look at some of the most influential Black leaders in American history during this month of February, in which we have set aside as Black History Month. Each week, we will take a look at three heroic men and women from the past that have endured hardship, oppression, physical abuse, and even death at the hands of those whose very mission it was to break the spirit of every Black man, woman, and child and force them to succumb to a system of bigoted control over anyone who did not look like them. So join us each week as we highlight these heroes who, through God's help and incredible faith, have paved the way for a better future for Black Americans and other oppressed people of color in this nation and abroad.
Since
1979. Our first Black hero of faith is Desmond Tutu. Bishop Desmond Tutu was born in 1931 in South Africa. In 1975, he was appointed Dean of St. Mary's Cathedral in Johannesburg, the first Black to hold that position. From 1976 to 1978, he was the Bishop of Lesotho, and in 1978 became the first Black General Secretary of the South African Council of Churches. Bishop Desmond Tutu has formulated his objective as helping to develop a democratic and just society without racial divisions, and set forward the following points as minimum demands. Number one, equal civil rights for all. Number two, the abolition of South Africa's passport laws. Number three, a common system of education. Number four, the cessation of forced deportation from South Africa to the so-called homeland. Bishop Tutu was most known for his opposition to apartheid in South Africa, for which he received the Nobel Peace Prize in 1984. Next up, Thurgood Marshall. On August 30th, 1967, Thurgood Marshall became the first African-American U.S. Supreme Court justice. Grandson of an enslaved person, Marshall lived through some of the most trying times of race relations in American history. This undoubtedly shaped his legal philosophy. Known for his earlier work in helping end legal segregation through the 1954 landmark case, Brown versus Board of Education, he once described his judicial approach by simply saying, "You do what you think is right and let the law catch up."
Beyond the sky, it's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Somebody keep telling me don't hang around. It's been a long, long time coming.
And our last black hero of faith is Mary McCloud-Bethune. Mary Jane McCloud-Bethune, born July 10th, 1875, lived until May 18th, 1955. She was an American educator, stateswoman, philanthropist, humanitarian, and civil rights activist. Bethune founded the National Council of Negro Women in 1935 and resided as president or leader for a myriad of African American organizations, including the National Association for Colored Women and the National Youth Administration's Negro Division. She also was appointed as a national advisor to President Franklin Delano Roosevelt, whom she worked with to create the Federal Council on Colored Affairs, also known as the Black Cabinet. She is well known for starting a private school for African American students in Daytona Beach, Florida. It later continued to develop as Bethune-Cookman University. Bethune was the only African American woman officially a part of the U.S. delegation that created the United Nations Charter. For her lifetime of activism, she was deemed acknowledged First Lady of Negro America by Ebony Magazine in 1949. She was known as the First Lady of the Struggle because of her commitment to gain better lives for African Americans.